Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the president of Grom Social Enterprises, Paul Ward. Paul, so great to have you on with us today.
Good morning, Natalie. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. Now let's introduce you to our investor community. How does Grom Social Enterprises specialize in social media and kids entertainment?
Okay, so let me dive right in. We basically run a portfolio business that has a number of assets. Our core business is Grom Social, which is a social media opportunity for kids under the age of 13. Not everyone may be aware, but most apps do not let children under the age of 13 on without parental consent. A number of them, of course, find their way into TikTok, Instagram, and so forth. But there are laws that are about to be enacted, particularly in California in January, that are going to hold these big social accountable for not frustrating the process and letting kids on. The reason that kids under 13 are not supposed to be on is you're not supposed to sell their data. And we don't do that. At Grom Social, we never sell their data. And we have been hard at work behind the scenes. Within the portfolio, we call Grom Social the mothership because it was the first brand that we created. And we've been behind the scenes really putting a lot of investment and a lot of energy into completely overhauling the app, which we're going to unveil in late Q3, because we really want to give kids a safe social media opportunity, that they're not going to find anywhere else, and allowing us to really give kids a great place to go once they're not going to be able to access the other apps that they're not supposed to be on to begin with.
So, Paul, what exactly is the Grom Social app going to entail for kids?
So the Grom Social app is going to have a number of great camera features, video programming, and basic social media opportunities. If I could give you an example, really what sets Grom Social apart is that we invite parents to play an active role in their kids' social media. And we really do keep them safe because we have algorithms that intercept hate speech, abusive language, and just inappropriate content. But also, as a parent, if my son Charlie were 9 years old, he's a little bit older than that, but if he were 9 years old, I could sign him up for Grom and have full visibility on all of his activity, who he's speaking with, who he's friends with, and it gives parents great parental control. And we bolstered the entire experience with live monitors. So a child can't just simply post a video without going through the filtering process before it makes it onto Grom. We just make sure that it passes muster. And if a child goes to post a video that has inappropriate content in it, the child will get a notification that basically says, Natalie, thanks for trying. It didn't meet our standards. But in the new app that we're, in the rebrand that we're doing, parents will now get notified at the same time as their child. So it really, we call training wheels for social media. Every kid is going to be on social, and we see a great opportunity to really engage with parents and encourage them to use Grom as training wheels for when their child is old enough to actually, be on social on their own.
Yeah, it really does sound like a good gateway for kids to become familiar with social media without diving in and getting lost in some crazy content out there.
Absolutely.
With that in mind, we're getting to late 2023 where you're saying the launch is expected to happen. What is going to be taking place in that timeline to get to that point?
So we're doing a number of things. We are working with UI and UX professionals that have been completely overhauling, the look, the logo, the experience. We're going to unveil an entire library of avatar characters and features. So on our app, no child will have their own photo as their profile pic. It's an avatar where you can go in and choose hats, sunglasses, backpacks, jeans, fun accessories, cool sneakers and things like that. And so it really is a very unique experience for kids. We want to keep it childlike. you know, it's all about kids first. You know, I spent the bulk of my career at Nickelodeon and Nick at Night. And, you know, all of our success came when we listened to kids and we gave them, you know, what they wanted. And we really want to give them this robust experience, because we never want Grom Social to feel like a concession to kids because they want it to be on another social media platform.
Mm-hmm. Get the slime, Paul.
Exactly. I got plenty of it.
So. Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Sounds incredible. And I look forward to more updates with you about it.
Absolutely.
Again, the president of Grom Social Enterprises, Paul Ward.